Good morning, or afternoon, or evening, and welcome. I'm Reid Krell, and this is the Law of Real Property. In this video, I'm going to be talking about the expectations I have for you, the expectations you should have for me, the structure of the class, the syllabus, and e-learning. Please let me know if anything that I'm going to be asking of you will be difficult or impossible given your technical needs. First, my expectations. Now let me start by saying that there is absolutely no reason why anyone should fail this class. You're all smart. You wouldn't be here if you weren't smart. In my experience as a teacher, students who fail my classes overwhelmingly do so because they don't do the work. It is not impossible to complete all of the assignments and still fail, but it is very difficult. So let's start there. I expect you to show up ready and willing to do the work. Next, let me temper that first expectation with this. Life happens so much all the time and never more so than now. So we're in the middle of a global pandemic. On what you expect, both in terms of your learning experience and the rest of your life. You may not even be in Barbados. You may be in your home country. You may have extra caregiving responsibilities or extra hours at work, or even be concerned about how you will pay your bills. All of these things are real and legitimate, and they affect your ability to work on things for this class. So I expect that life when it does, you don't need to be worried. I will exercise any discretion that I have in your favor. Now, there are limits. I can't violate university or campus or faculty policy, but anything that I can do to help you succeed is on the table. Now, let's talk about what you need to succeed in this class. First of all, you will need a reliable high-speed internet connection and a device that will access. If you are living in the halls of residence, you should have the connection and only need the device. If you're living elsewhere and you do not feel that your internet connection will support synchronous learning, please advise me as soon as possible. If you have device concerns, please advise me as soon as possible. Second, you need to know where to go for this class. If you're in Barbados and choose to attend class face-to-face, you should go to the Roy Marshall Teaching Complex, Lecture Theater 1, aware, only a certain number of people will be admitted to the class, and once the seats are full, no one else can come. If you intend to attend synchronously online, the Zoom link and password will be posted in e-learning. If you intend to attend asynchronously, all lectures and tutorials will be recorded, and the link to the recording will be posted in e-learning. Now, right now, I honestly don't know whether the recordings themselves will be posted in learning or whether they'll be posted on my YouTube channel and a link provided. If you choose to attend synchronously but remotely, let me be very clear. You are not required to turn on your camera in my class. I would be delighted if you did because the feedback of your faces is helpful to me. But do not worry about the messiness of your surroundings. Do not worry about your clothes or makeup, although, yes, please do wear clothes. Do not worry about your pets or children or partners. Anything that comes along is fine. We're all being a lot more intimate with one another than we like to be these days, and that's okay. We can be messy with one another about that. You are permitted to record class sessions. Now, I am supposed to record each class session, but the truth is that I am a forgetful person. And I may not always remember to do so. If recording is sort of broadly permitted, then on the days that I screw up and forget to record, I can call on you guys to cover my lines. In order to access this course and complete the readings, you will need to be able to access and use e-learning, Zoom, Lexis and Westlaw, again, just drop by and see if you can find me. If you can't access it, let me know and we'll find an alternative way for you to talk to me. Other ways to contact me are on the syllabus and include my email, office phone, WhatsApp, and Twitter. If you run into technical issues, please contact Campus IT Services at itservicedesk@kville.ue.edu. If you ask me your technical questions, I can promise that the only thing I will tell you is to contact SIS. And if you're the 10th technical question I've gotten in a day, I'm likely to be a little hurt about it. Now, what can you expect from me? You can expect lots of technical mistakes. We didn't hire me to do IT work, but here we are. You can expect me to be forgetful. There's a lot on my plate and stuff slips past me. When it slips past me to your benefit, like forgetting due dates and letting you submit things late, you get the benefit. When it slips past me to your detriment, like I forget grade stuff, we will find a way to mitigate that. You can also expect that I will sort of move the class along. So we'll continue to tell you what you need as days go by and where we are as the course goes on. You can expect me in general to be human. And I hope that you will extend to me the same grace and humanity that I extend to you in those circumstances. This class will be structured in a way similar to most classes at the Faculty of Law this semester. Synchronous recorded high-flex lectures and synchronous recorded online tutorials. There will be some written work associated with tutorials which you will submit via e-learning, but the vast majority of your grade will be based on your final exam. I will assign you to particular breakout groups within your tutorials, and you will work with this group the entire semester. Finally, the syllabus is available on e-learning. It contains my policies and procedures and the reading schedule. Please note that the reading includes cases listed on the worksheet, so please make sure you have reviewed those cases before we discuss those topics. Let me close with this. Like I said, we're all smart here. So I want to encourage you to stand out by being kind. I want to tell you a story related to that. A friend of mine has a boss at a firm in North Alabama who heard through the grapevine that opposing counsel's brother had died. Unprompted, not asked for, the boss sent opposing counsel an email agreeing to suspend all pending deadlines. And he offered to file the motion himself if opposing counsel would advise him of how much time he needed. Another story. A well-respected partner at a large regional firm in the U.S. that I know that I have an acquaintance with has been having anxiety issues and panic attacks. One of the things that causes her panic is the prospect of having to tell her partners that she needs to take time off. Now, when she finally screwed her courage to the sticking place and told her partners that she needed to take time off and come off her cases while she did so, the answer was, take all the time you need. We'll handle everything for you. Your job will be here when you get back, and we just want you to get better. In case you were wondering, I am telling you to be these kinds of lawyers. Don't be the kind of lawyers that would take advantage of one another, because that's the way to have a profession where the world thinks that we're all a bunch of snakes. And you deserve better than that. With that, please make sure that you have reviewed the first worksheet before class tomorrow. I will likely record another lecture tonight or in the morning to get us more or less caught up